Hi, welcome to today's session of Random Talking. So today's topic is routine. So I think I've completed individually each of the tasks I used to do, like, you know, swimming, horse riding, diary writing and all that. So I thought I'll put it together and, you know, finalize the whole story. So summer holidays is the time where all these things used to happen. I can give you a brief of my day otherwise also. So summer vacations, I'm 5 years old, I wake up at 5 in the morning and the first activity is I have to do, so 5 in the morning I wake up, so basics is like 20 minutes, so 5 brushing, washroom and all that, 5:20 I have to start counting from 1 to 100 in Hindi. So after I reach like third stanza, so first and second stanza, I'm counting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, so I have to point with a, you know, stick, which is the military stick. It's got a metal on the top and a black part on the bottom. So I'm like, ek, do, teen, char. And loudly I have to count. So I start, you know, my dad who's in the washroom or bathroom or kitchen, wherever he is, or in the living room, can hear me count. So I had to finish till 100. So after Thursday, I told, this is very boring, I'm doing the same thing. Then he's like, okay, do, let's change it. You do from 100, reverse, from 100 to 1 you count. And that helped me how? Because in fourth standard, one teacher, Hindi teacher, she told, any child can count reverse from 100 to, you know, 1. And in a Hindi school where I was very pathetic in Hindi, in a Hindi school in the sense all my, you know, other students, most of them are, you know, North Indian. So their basic language was Hindi. So I was like, they were like, count from 100 to 1 and none of them were able to count and didn't even give it a try. I was like, I can do this. And, you know, my teacher was like, you are that kid who doesn't even get marks. You know, your spellings are all trash. It's like, I'm that kid, but I can do this. So it's like 109, so like 100, 99, 98, 97, 96. I go like that. So all the way from 100 to 1, I say, now I really don't know if I can do that in the reverse. But yeah, that was that. Oh, there's an aeroplane that's going. Yeah. So 199 and till 1 I had to go. And I did that and the whole class was like clapping for me. I was like, yeah, this is it. Somewhere we used what we, you know, did for 3-4 years. So that was, so first thing is, you know, counting 1 to 100. Second thing is counting tables. Counting tables, you know, learning tables from 2 ones till 20 ones every single day. So 2 ones 2. I have a book. So I have to, you know, measure like 2 ones 2, 2 twos 4, 2 threes 6. It goes like that all the way till 20 ones. And this was super helpful for me when it came to my competitive exams. And my math exams always, because, you know, 17 eights are right now, I can't tell, trust me. So I have a bad memory, like, but I'm very good, like pictorial memory is what I have. Like I can see the page if I'm continuously, you know, revising every day, not like once in a blue moon, I sit and see the page. It doesn't, you know, appear in my head. So that way, that was, you know, fantastic to do my max papers and all that. It quite helped me, tables. But I hated it, yeah, like routine every day you do counting 8 to 100 and 2 ones are till 21. That's super boring. But trust me, when it came to routine, I kind of fell off the routine grid for some, you know, very badly I fell off the routine grid. And, you know, it was super stressful for me to even think of having a routine. So from there, you know, I was like, how did I do it as a kid? I was like, yeah, I did it. So I can't, you know, it's not impossible mission. I can do it. So that way I could kind of put back myself to waking up at 5 now. So yeah, after that, like, you know, 5:30, right? So at 5:30 I have to leave home. Previous day only we would have packed all my swimsuit and everything. So swimsuit I'm already wearing. And on top of that, I wear my clothes so that when I go to the swimming pool, like full open and immediately jump into the water kind of thing. No, time waste is very, time is very precious. You can't be wasting it at all, according to my dad, okay? So on the swimwear, I wear all my clothes and things and I dressed by 5:30. We are leaving home. All my bag, it's like a small basket. Remember the olden days basket where that had a handle? Lunch used to go to school. That kind of plastic. It's made of plastic. This one, you know, basket, and I take that. I've got my towels in that and all my, you know, other dress to change when I return after swimming. All of that. And I go and my dad take the bus from, there's almost 700, 800 meters to the bus stop. So he walking is equivalent for me to run even now. Like there, back then my legs were small and I was running behind him. There's no change now. He's walking. I'm still running like a tiny kid behind him. So yeah, he's super fast. He's like a rocket. So it's like within 7 minutes we finished 700 meters, like 100 meters 1 minute kind of a speed, like killer speed used to go. I was like so done even by the time we reach the bus stop, and then the bus comes early morning 5:30, like super cold, and we'll be sweating because we're running. And nobody in the world can understand why we're sweating. So like, okay, we get into the bus. The bus reaches, and there's another a kilometer from there, that bus stop, to, you know, walk back to the swimming pool. So that's near Stella Maris School, okay, Sadashiv Nagar. KC Red, back then it was called KC Reddy Swimming Pool. So I used to go there, and you know, 5, 6 o'clock. So 6 o'clock batch is the first batch. 6, 7, 8, 9. I think there's a 10 o'clock batch. Yeah, 10 o'clock batch. That's the last batch. So there are 5 batches in the morning. So I used to go for the first batch, and water is super cold. Super cold. Bangalore, yeah. Even it's summer, it's super cold. And the thing with 6 o'clock batch is not very crowded. The other batches, so because it's summer holidays, everybody's having summer holidays. Like, too much crowd in that pool. So, 5 years old, I used to go there, and I think my swimming story is there. Like, you know, getting beaten, getting kicked. So, I'm super scared. Even now, I'm kind of having a slight scare, fear of heights. I think it's, so in a swimming pool, they have that ladder to climb, and from a height, they kind of make you jump. I did that twice. I hated that thing. I was like very scared. I used to go, like, I used to see children before me and get scared because, like, they were part of the swimming pool training, okay? Small children, like third, seventh, fourth, even I am small. So all of us were there, like 10, 15 of those children used to jump. So when they used to jump, my dad used to send me also, you also go jump with them. I'm like, I'm not part of that swimming, you know, training club or whatever that was. And he's like, it's okay, you go. I used to go, and they used to be jumping, and the instructor, these children, they're shivering, okay, they're trembling. I didn't have that shiver when I get out of the water, but they're like trembling like that, all that, you know, teeth level trembling, and then this fellow pushes them off, and I'm like, when you're the next person, and you see this instructor who's standing there and pushing them off, it's like severely damaging your morals. I'm like, I'll do it on my own, but they're like, I know, and even I was pathetic. I reached there, I'm like, no, I don't want to jump and all, and then I think I kind of leapt on my own, but still I didn't quite like it because it's quite high. Let's say, I think it was some 200 meter height or something. 200 meter, 1 meter is 3.3 feet. So that's like 66 feet. Oh no, that cannot be so high. 66 feet is like 6 floors. It's basically 30 feet, okay? 30 feet height. So like 3 floor heights. Third floor. From the third floor terrace, we're jumping, kind of a scenario. Okay. So that jumping is over, swimming is over, run half an hour swimming, then half an hour getting ready, and then coming back home. And when you're going in the bus and coming back in the bus, my dad used to be like, recite the bus stop names. You know, remember, you know, the BMTC buses used to be like, Mundane Niladana. That was recently it started doing that Mundina Niladana. Back in the day, it was not. Like, conductor only used to call out, this stop. So there were around 16 bus stops till the place, from my house till the, you know, Sankey, what is that called? Sadashiv Nagar bus stop. I used to say Palace Ground and go, okay? So Palace Gutali. Used to be like, Palace Gutali Ogata. When you get into the bus, used to ask, like, Palace Kutali Ogata. And they'd be like, Barney. Early morning 5:30, they know, like, you know, this kid is going. So my dad's like, you only have to ask, you only have to get in. And then he used to buy 1.5. I'm that half the kid, no? It's like tiny kid. So yeah, I used to go, and you know, I used to recite from my bus stop till that bus stop. Without, you know, from my memory, I was supposed to recite all the bus stops to him. My dad used to not forget. I don't know. I had a huge problem with Ganganalli and Aarti Nagar. No, Ganganalli and, yeah, Ganganalli bus stop and CBI. CBI and Ganganalli. I didn't know which came first. Like, that just didn't sit into my head. That way I kind of learned, you know, mapping. So that trained my mind to map the road. I was not so good at it, but I was okay. For my, you know, third standard, fourth standard brain, that was a big issue. So while coming back also, I was supposed to say the bus stops, like, in order. And if I missed a bus stop, I had to start from scratch, okay? People used to be like, oh my god, she's like super getting assed, kicking in her asses. I mean, coming back is like 9 in the morning, like everybody's going to office and you're like full dead tired after swimming and all. And swimming, like, puts you off balance, right? Like, climbing that stairs after you swim, it's kind of, you feel heavy, right? I'm like, okay, after that, you're sick, so tired, and then you have to walk another kilometer to the bus stop, take a bus, get home. After you get home, wash the, you know, swim clothes because it's full chlorine and things. Then I have to again take shower because, you know, again, chlorine and etc. So shower and wash the clothes, put it for drying on top. Then come back, eat. I used to eat breakfast. At 5:30, we used to have breakfast and go for swimming, okay? Thankfully, otherwise I would have fainted only mostly. So 5:30, we used to eat and then go, okay, breakfast is already done. So you come back and then you can, you know, munching, crunching, lot of things, biscuits and lot of other stuff. Mostly used to be there, biscuits and things. So yeah, all the cream biscuits and nice things. And I'll eat that. After that, I have to write my first report, okay? Report writing started when I was in fourth, not before that. So first report I have to write, and I have to write the report, what, you know, from morning 5 o'clock till 11 o'clock, what happened. That's the report, and I have to write both sides. I'll be like, this bus, we walked 700 meters to the bus stop. Daddy ran at this speed. I was at, you know, a little more lesser speed. We got into this bus number 282. It went at this pace. What else do you write for like 4 hours? And every single day we're repeating the same thing. Sometimes I'll be like, bus number is not, I don't remember, but my dad remembers. So I had to remember the bus number very correctly. Can't go wrong. I was 6 and I used to write that. And after that's over, I think I had to study. So 1 month school is there, no? So we already got the books and textbooks and everything. So I used to study for one and a half hour. I used to like that part because, you know, when you get back to school and then you're like full, I know the answer to this. That's a feeling of, you know, prestige. First 2 months of after school starts, after summer vacation, no, I'd be like super intelligent. After that, I become, you know, average student. Because, yeah, it kind of gave me that, you know, launch for the year, because I wasn't very on the go learner, very slow. So that way it gave me an inch edge over the others, and which kind of kept my confidence level high, which was super good because of all the kind of things that happened. So yeah, when I entered 6th standard, I was like already prepped up, you know, when I studied and already entered. After summer vacation, I go to the new school. I'm like all answering, everybody's like, how does she know? I'm like, yeah, padhai kiya humne ghar mein. But I didn't tell that to school. Like, obviously, we were playing street smart back then, because nothing good happened till 6th standard at least. So, in street smart, you're like, no, we're, you know, born intelligent types. But no, I wasn't so intelligent also. It's like, you know, hard work, too much hard work and blessings. At least to remember whatever I kind of put the hard work for. So that blessing was blessing and grace from God is there. So that way I was able to answer in class, and I kind of got that thing. Okay, we can do this. And I started studying well from 6th standard. So that kind of, you know, the launch was, you know, studying a little extra during summer holidays for one hour is the only thing. Then I have lunch by, you know, home lunch used to be like 11:30, 12 o'clock was lunch. Yeah, obviously morning 5:30 is breakfast, means 12 o'clock is lunch. School timings, okay, school 11:45 to 12:15 used to be lunch, 12:40, 12:30 used to be lunch break. So we used to have by same timings only. So 12:15 finished lunch, then I have to sit and draw one painting, watercolor. Not like the ones I draw now. Nowadays, I have no skill, no talent, and, you know, I just want to finish, but I want to draw and I want to color, kind of a thing. But back then, I really used to put a lot of effort. It used to be like something which kind of really, really interests me. And on Saturdays, I had to read this open CSIM book from, you know, paper, newspaper, children's newspaper from, which used to come in Deccan Herald. Every Saturday, it used to come. And every article I had to read, and my dad used to ask questions from the article. If I don't give the right answer, then I have to read that, you know, that article again and reply. And he remembered every detail of everything he read. Yeah, so amazing memory. Like, yeah, he does. So, Not right now. Right now he's kind of lost with his memory, but otherwise he has good memory when he reads something, and he had to ask some questions and all properly, has to get tuned. So reading skills. So he kind of brought in reading skills. Okay, like Saturdays. So then after that, 1 o'clock I start drawing. By 2:30, 3 o'clock is when I finish my watercolors. Then I have to do a portrait. Portrait, I had a sketching book. So from that I have to see and write. So for both of this, I have to take out two A4 sheet, A4 white sheet, and draw on that. So from the portrait, it used to be mostly Gandhiji. He was like, I want you to get a perfect Gandhi, and any time in the world they ask you to draw, within 10-15 minutes you should be able to draw that. I trust me, that Gandhi was not like a 10-15 minute drawable Gandhi. It used to take me 45 minutes to an hour, and I'm not good at repeating the same thing I've drawn. Like, first time I draw it with like full attention and I can do it, but second time if you ask me to repeat the same painting or drawing, it never comes out well. Because I kind of lost interest, and it's like a repetition. I'm bad at it. bad at repeating stuff. So second time, you know, he used to ask me to draw and I'm like, no. So you know that finally, and I have to, after I draw, I had to file it. I had to write the date on the top, art by Cheryl V, just like art by Cheryl V. And at the base, and you have to put a boundary to, you know, boundary outline, unless it's like watercolors. Yeah, watercolors also boundary outline, because then only you can write the date and the base art by Cheryl. So I used to write that, and after that is the handwriting bit. So, you know, 2 to 2.5 hours of handwriting. Tea was served, you know, tea used to happen at 4 to 4:30. That's the time. So when I'm eating is the only time where I can watch TV, okay? So yeah, I kind of started eating a lot because I could watch TV for longer. Yeah, we find strategies, right? So that was one of my strategy, and yeah, to watch TV, all in the name of TV. But yeah, so, and I liked food, okay? I really loved food. And what do you say? So chai time is over. Chai ke saath some crisp thing will be there. And after that's over, 4:30. So 4:30 my painting sketching is over. Then I have some time, right? Five to seven. I don't know what I did. Then 7 o'clock. I had to write. 6:30 to 7 was report writing. So the next part of the day. So from 11 o'clock, what happened? After I finished swimming, drying, and then from there onwards, like, you know, lunch happened, I did this painting, this is what happened, I put watercolor, this didn't work out, it didn't come out well, I'm sorry. Sometimes I've written a letter also, I'm very sorry, and I had to write. So both these reports have to be filed, morning one and evening one. And, you know, both these paintings have to be, so writing skills improved because of that. And, you know, I could map my day. After that, in 6th to 7th, I told my daddy I wanted diary. So diary writing also started in 7th. So during summer vacation also 7th, you know, after all this is over, 7 to 7:30 prayer, 7:30 to 8 dinner, then 8 onwards, you know, diary writing, 8 to 8:30 or 8:15, whenever that sleeping time is, you know, diary writing, and then I can sleep. So after I do all this, every single day, this has to be done except on Sunday. Sunday, there's only one report I got to write. That's about what the priest told in the church. Sunday, we have to go to church. So after the church prayer service, that's like called as mass, we used to come back home and my be like, what was told in the church? You got to write that report. And that mom has. So my mom is a correction person for all the writing part, okay? Because her spellings are too good. This convent kid knows spellings. Even now, when she's reading paper, she'll be like learning spellings. So she's like that spelling queen in the house, okay? Even now, like, my dad's like around me and he's like, what's the spelling of this? And I'm like, I'm telling him the spelling. He still doesn't trust me. He'll be like, Sita, you tell. He trusts my mom. And I'm like, why do you even ask? Like, you have no trust in my spelling. Why do you ask me? And it's like, you also know it might be wrong, so you might learn it from her. I'm like, you didn't learn all that. So yeah, it keeps happening. Negotiation and debates happen. And so she had to do this correction and I had to keep the copy ready. So my dad used to come back after work by 7:30 or 8, 7:30, 8-ish kind of a thing, okay? And he used to check on all my material. So he used to read. First, he used to look at my drawings. So watercolor one he sees, he's like, okay, this is not great. This part, the bridge is gone. So he's like, what did you see and draw? And he's like, okay, mostly watercolors used to not have so much rejection. But the portrait part, like I said, first time I draw and next time it's not great. So he's like, once he saw my Gandhiji and he was freaked out. He's like, this took you 1 hour, 15 minutes. I said, yeah, it took me 1 hour, 15 minutes. And he's like, he circled the whole piece, like from the nose till the mouth. Actually, it was terribly, terribly bad. It's like got crunched. Gandhiji's face got crunched in the base portion. He circled it and he said, what bullshit is this kind of a thing? Then he used to check my handwriting. All the, you know, every date wise handwriting. That scam I told you, right? Like, I kind of used to change the date. Yeah, so handwriting bit he used to check. And he used to go by every alphabet and the whole page, all those alphabet A to Z. In a line, I had to write in a four line book one. So I had like three books to write. One is cursive writing. One is, you know, a capital A to Z. And one is one stylish writing A, B, C. Stylish, not very stylish. Just like I got used to writing. So I had like block letters. My handwriting was bad. So my third son, she told, so her handwriting is like, we can't discover what she's written. Like even I couldn't read what I was writing. So she told, this is not helpful. So yeah. Writing, handwriting was a mandatory thing. And so basically writing became a major part of the story. So after that, my mom had to correct. So my handwriting and all, no correction. So she had to correct this reports which I used to write at 11 o'clock and 6:30. So these two reports, she has to, you know, a lot of spelling mistakes used to be there, like hell. Not spelling, it's also the grammar errors, you know, like semicolon, colon, comma, full stop, starting a new, you know, sentence, all that she used to correct. And she had to, so my dad was like, she has to correct it in red pen only. And madam will not correct till it's 7 o'clock, 7:30. And my dad used to, she'll be like, you will get beaten if it's not, correction is not done by 8 o'clock. I'm like, mama, please, please, it's 7:30, correct, no. I used to be begging, so, yeah, too much stress. Even after doing my work, I had to beg for, you know, approval and all that, and I had to get it approved by 8 o'clock and keep it ready. So, he used to come, he used to be like, okay, he used to read through my day, and he was like, okay, seems good, after swimming. So, morning, he used to take me for swimming, right? So, after that, he used to go to his work. He used to change from there only and go to work. And I that's why, so my mom used to come. So my mom and I used to come back home after that. So that's how the day is connected. Correct. I was just thinking, what? How did it happen? I came back. So only while going, I had to tell the bus stops, not while coming back. Correct. Corrections. Okay. Little corrections, because it's been a long time. So that was my typical summer vacation one day. And then when I was in 10th standard, I was like, now though I was like, you know, this. No activity can break down my, you know, mental strength. And, you know, then he, this, like, my dad understood, she's got very comfortable in life. Let's introduce horse riding. I was like, oh, freaking. And then, like, you know, horse riding, and the horse rode me. I don't know how far I rode the horse. Like, the horse knew the way. It was like, oh, 35 day course. Okay. Some 1,800, 2,000 rupees for the entire course. And, you know, tuck. First, you train in a circular ring. So, ring training happened for 7 days. You have to get that up and down on the horse. And then you go on a... So, palace ground is where that... palace ground... You remember all those Kalyan Mantaps are there. There's a last thing called as Prince's Academy. So, that used to be the place where horse riding trainings used to happen. And proper jockeys used to come for training, okay? And I think I was the only girl back then, you know, who used to come for horse riding classes. And I was in 10th. I was too big. Basically, all these, generally, they come from a smaller age and then they go up, kind of a thing. So, it's like 10th standard, you want to do this? And it's like, what to do? We're doing this. So, horse riding happened. I was terrible at climbing, getting down and all. And that was the only thing in 10th standard. Once I did, 1 year I did, I'm like, oh, good namaskara. So, I was horse riding. And routine, you know, after school, so after school, morning in the school days also, you know, tables and counting 1 to 100 in Hindi was fixed. After I came back home, I had to study right hand writing for 2 hours, then study, then prayer, dinner, writing my diary, sleeping. That was like a pattern. And my diary writing also, my mom had to correct. So three things my mom had to correct. One is my 11 o'clock report, 6:30 report, and my diary writing. Diary writing, in the end, I had to have a column called advantages and disadvantages. So, what's the good part of the day, bad part of the day, I had to highlight. I mean, now I'm not writing a diary. I feel I should write, but then I'm like, no. Never went back and read any of it, but when I used to write, it used to be, it's like, it kind of accounts for your entire day, and then you're calm and relaxed, and you're like, okay, I did my best for the day. And you hold yourself accountable. So that gives you an accountability mirror. So routine is good. And getting back on a routine was super difficult after, you know, a break in my kind of balance zone. So I'm back on my routine and I'm doing good. And, you know, how I could start back, initially, even the smallest of things, when I, you know, couldn't make it, I was like, you know, panic attack. I'm like, I'm not doing this. And then I thought, okay, let's introduce slowly. And eventually go from there and not have a timetable. So previously I used to write on like timetables and it was like following and tick mark and all that. So now I had to slowly, you know, start from one, you know, thing. So I slowly started in putting it back one by one. And having a routine really helped. And morning waking up on time, sleeping at the same time really, really works wonders. And get enough sleep. Sleep is the medicine for everything, according to me. Like, you're sick, you sleep. You're tired, you sleep. Getting sleep is important. There's no fun in, you know, binge watching, Netflixing. Not worth it. get your proper 7 hours. I mean, mine is a standard 7 to 8 hours is my sleep cycle, whatever is working for you. If it's like 6, great. You have additional 1 hour. So keep smiling, have a routine, sleep on time, get up on time, be happy, be a killer. Ta-ta, bye-bye.